everyone. This is Smothered Run, and welcome to Kerbal Space Program 1.3.1. And this is my attempt at the Jool 5 challenge at Jeb's level. The rocket on the pad is sitting on a modular launch pad from Alpha Mensae's mod. Here goes the crew access arm, as well as the launch escape systems support that you would normally find on a Saturn V rocket, but instead I just had it sitting on basically the nose cone of this, just because, why not? Extra part, it's fun. So the booster's made up of 6 solid rocket motors. They are some of the biggest ones, if not the biggest ones, you can get from KW Rocketry, as well as 2 liquid-fueled Griffin motors, and they're on the 2 strap-on liquid-fuel boosters that have the solid rocket fuel booster strapped onto them. Kerbal, yes. So there's going to be actually 2 refueling missions, actually 3 refueling missions. So I'm not even carrying any xenon fuel either. So here we're coming up to the solid rocket booster separation. And I've actually put this back to regular speed. And so we're going to have booster separation in just a few seconds. Here we go. Wait for lag. And then full speed again. 4 times regular speed again. Although, I do really like the sound of those engines. Those Griffins sound awesome. So here we are, we're gonna keep launching, and because this is for a challenge, I'm gonna stop talking, but I'm gonna play the accelerated ascent up until we get to, I don't know, somewhere. Make it up as I go along. And I have the resource panel open for no other reason than for the challenge, so that as part of the rules, they want to see as much of the resource panel as possible, basically, especially at important parts. So to me, launches are important, so here you go. I'm indicating with my hand, and of course nobody can see my hand. That's fine. In just a couple seconds, I'm going to engage modular rocket systems, nuclear engines. They're basically four Nervas strapped together with the power of four and the cost of four to four and a half. I can't remember, but they're expensive. And in a couple seconds, we're gonna separate the liquid engines as we go back to regular speed. And that made me nervous. That made me very nervous. I'm glad I didn't put all of the fuel in those little booster separators. So anyways, we have a apoapsis of about 262, almost 263 kilometers, and our desired apoapsis is going to be 300. However, to get this heavy monster into space and to stay in space, I'm going to need to do a burn up to about 350, 360 kilometers for the apoapsis before I start trying to circularize. Otherwise, this thing does not go in space. Correction, this thing does not stay in space. So, and in just a moment, we're going to accelerate time again. More shots of Kerbin shining down on my cool little spaceship. So this whole process using OBS at 30 frames per second for 720p was about an hour, 1 hour and 10 minutes. Power Director 16's screen capture. It took an hour and a half, 2 hours to do. It was quite a long haul. So So here I'm opening up the rear cargo bay doors to expose my radiators and activate them. I have two that are independent of that actual action group because they need to be retracted when this thing lands. And while this thing uses its ISRUs, yes, this vessel is going to use ISRUs to refuel, because I do not have the fuel, even with a number of gravity assists, to land this vessel. Yes, this vessel will land on at least one planet, one moon of Jool, and make it back. So, it's not going to land on Tylo, or Leia. I have a lander and a space plane specifically designed for those two bodies. And you might be asking, or not, if I have radiators extended to where my solar panel is. This vessel is not solar powered. It runs entirely on nuclear reactors. Approximately 10 years plus of running the reactors. I have no idea if that's enough. We shall see. So we're at 370 kilometers and slowly starting our pitch over to circularize. Again, even at 6 times time acceleration, this is going to take a while. That alarm you just heard was dang it telling me that I've got a problem with a battery somewhere, and I didn't bother looking for it until much later, and we don't even know if I'm going to be able to fix it. I've had issues with dang it in 1.3. I don't know if I'm doing it right. There was one launch where I had a fuel tank leak and I was never able to fix it. There's another couple launches where I had engine troubles, as in an engine stopped working. I was never able to fix it, even sending up a 5-star engineer. So, I'm not sure if that was part of how it works. But that's again just the battery telling me it's dead. So I ended up disabling all of the failures with engines and failures with fuel tanks. I've got enough failures with other stuff, I'm pretty sure I'll be okay. I can still make it a challenge. And plus TAC life support. And I have trouble with that in just a little bit. Because I got found out later, I got silly. And did something stupid. coming up to where I start to circularize, and that part takes very long too, so I'm just going to switch it to 6x10 acceleration, otherwise this video would be over an hour and a half long. So say thanks to Nice Man. And here we go, 6x time acceleration, and we're going to circularize. As the keen observer will have noticed, I've gone past my apoapsis, and I'm starting to fall back towards Kerbin. Now, I did this numerous times in practice, in another save, and it mostly worked, only the odd failure, stupid phone. Failure as in crash back into Kerbin and irradiate the entire surface. So, this one looks like it's actually performing better this time than it has others, and I'm actually at the same point, bringing down my overall apoapsis to closer to that 300 that I'm actually shooting for, so far it's win-win. A few more things about the actual vessel itself. I call it Vivi because, well, I'm Canadian, and I will leave it at that, even for you guys to figure out as to why. And it has, as I mentioned, a lander for Tylo, and a space plane for Lathe, and also a space truck with its own little ISRU, just in case I have to land it somewhere and I don't need fuel. This vessel itself will actually land on Val, but it only works if I don't have the other landers on board. And now we're actually getting close to orbit. At this point I stop around 75 kilometers periapsis because I'm never going to make a half-decent orbit, circular orbit going this route, this far from apoapsis. 75, quick burn, stop, and then I'll loop around back to my, actually I think, yeah, sorry, I set up a maneuver node here to go kind of circularize, faff around with it a bit, and once I get it to where I want to go, time warp is our friend. Back at apoapsis, and we're going to circularize. Nice that the radiators have cooled down. Stock radiators, and the nuclear reactor won't be starting up anytime soon. That'll be starting up much later, closer to when we actually leave. So right now we're sitting about 45 days before our window to launch to Eve. Moon is just around Eve, and depending on what the numbers give us, we're either going to go Eve, Kerbin, Eve, Jool, or Eve, Jool, just depending on what the numbers give me. Much wraps it up here for the first episode. Finally circularized mostly, and I'm happy enough with it. A little beauty shot of the sun shining down on the vessel. Just trying to track down some stuff, and dang it, for some reason it's not there, not where I should be looking. But anyways, there's a picture of the Vimy, and we'll catch you around next time. See you everybody. This is the end of episode 1.